Guys, it's Nightwing 2303 from WearTesters.com. Today we have the performance review on the Jordan Mello M11. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get right into it.
All right, guys. So as you can see, the traction is just slightly different than the 29s. There is Mello branding along there, and then the grooves here are just a little bit thinner on certain sections. I did find these to be just slightly better than the 29, but not overly better. Not to where, you know, one is definitely 100% better than the other one. On clean courts, however, these things excelled. Dusty courts with thick dust globs, it was okay as long as you just kept wiping, but then there are certain courts where there's just like a lot of dust, a lot of just disgusting stuff like 24-hour fitness, and that stuff you just have to constantly wipe in order to get some decent traction. Outdoors, however, these happen to grip pretty well, especially on this particular court, so I was pretty excited about that. Now, as far as their cushion, they are using the flight plate once again, just in the forefoot, so it's unlocked zoom in the forefoot, and then you have a cored out Phylon heel for some compression, additional cushion, since there isn't an actual technology back there. And these feel really, really awesome underfoot. These have a slightly better bounce than the 29s, in my opinion, more along the lines of the Superfly 3. So if you wanted just a little bit more feeling under your forefoot, then this is going to give you that. If you wanted something that's less pronounced, then the 29 will probably be a better option. As far as the materials, this colorway, along with two others, are going to be synthetics, and then there's the Christmas Day colorway, which is a full-grain leather upper. And these guys just kind of mimic leather perfectly, so if you wanted something that's going to break in quickly, this is going to be that. And then these also offer much more support than something like the woven upper, so if you wanted more of a traditional feel with your basketball shoe, something what I like to call a little bit more old school, then this is going to be it. Kind of mixes that old school upper with that new school cushion, and it gives you a really nice combination of the two. As far as fit, I would go true to size. They do run a little bit narrow. They're pretty snug after every wear. Every time I put these on, you definitely feel how kind of snug and tight they are. It's something that I personally do enjoy, but if you're a wide footer, you're probably going to want to head to the store and at least try these on just to be sure. And then lockdown is awesome. Their flight web system works just as well as it has in all their previous models, and the heel lockdown is great. And then you also have this external heel Phylon piece that's attached to the actual midsole, and this is the heel counter, so it's keeping your foot from shifting side to side. Support on these were perfectly fine for me. The unlock zoom was not too pronounced, so it wasn't feeling unstable at all. And they do have a nice little outrigger here as well. And like I said earlier, their external foam counter works just as good as a TPU counter. It also reduces the weight quite a bit, so you're getting all that support without added weight to your shoe. And then you have the flight plate underfoot, which is giving you additional torsional support and arch support as well.
All right, guys, that pretty much takes care of everything. All of the performance information as far as their scores is gonna be right here. One thing to definitely note is Pete, the weight. This is the lightest Mello to date, and you can definitely feel it, especially once you lace them up. Something that I thought was actually pretty interesting because they are lighter than the Air Jordan 29. However, they do give you almost the same exact performance. The one thing is that they beef up that support a little bit. So if you want just a little bit more support along that upper, I'd probably go with this version versus the 29. If you were interested in this colorway, along with any of the other colorways, the Christmas Day colorway is premium leather, which is my personal favorite. You can grab them all now over at finishline.com. If you need any more information, you can always go to my site, WearTesters.com. And thank you guys for watching. So until next time, guys, have a good one.